Hello friends, in the earlier video I have discussed something on the basics of law, purpose of law, and now let us move forward with the sources of Indian mercantile law. First of all, as discussed, normally we come across with English mercantile law. And earlier when normally the Britishers were ruling in India, they were doing a trade normally in their hometown. And at that time normally we can find that normally there were normally many of the trades which were carried out by the ships. So in such case now again, to carry this material from India, normally they required the permission, for the permission of the customs, permission of normally the docks and other things. So in such case normally they decided that there must be common set of rules and regulations binding their trade. So in such case normally it was originated, the law originated at that time, and normally we find that even today it is in existence. Only what changes has taken place is rules and regulations are modified, and the existing amendments whatever is there, it is changed and modified further. New sections have come in force. This one, sir. Second type of law is statute law. Statute law is normally the branch of law which is imposed by the statute. Statute means an apex body, and today in India the highest court for us is Supreme Court. Once the judgment is given by the Supreme Court, it is final. Only the person who can deny normally the justice of Supreme Court is the President. Highest authority is President. Even if you don't get justice in Supreme Court, we can come and appeal before the President. President decides what the case is about and normally how the judgment has to be declared. That is one side. So, statute contains normally the respective rules and regulations based on whatever it is done. Next, third one is judicial decisions. The judicial decisions are normally based on the judiciary. That is, only judiciary in India has got law making power. So in such case normally we should understand that judicial decisions are based on hearing both the parties. So both the parties, we can name this first party as normally the plaintiff, and second party is the defendant. A plaintiff is the one who files the case in the court, and defendant is the one who defends the case. So in such case normally the plaintiff has to come across normally with what the case is about and on what ground normally the suit is filed, and then now again this the suit filed will be heard and normally examined again and again on the basis of your facts, evidences as well as the proofs. Okay, that is one side, and eyewitnesses, and then normally defendants defends the same by producing normally his evidence from his part, and then normally his eyewitnesses as well as normally the facts on the basis of his side. So in such case normally both the parties are given equal opportunities, equal chance to be heard, and now either the case is decided on the basis of judicial decisions in the form of judgment here. One point is there. Next is customs and usage. Now we live in the 21st century, so our customs have changed. So earlier we can find that normally the cases were prolonged for so many years. Now even today they exist. The cases started from 1980 till now, the judgment has not come. So why? Because they cannot conclude on what basis normally the decision has to be given, or on what basis the judgment has to be given. But still we can find that normally the customs and usage in India has to be again has been rampant in the past. Same thing is continuing now. So in such case normally we find that every person is normally declared as innocent person unless and until he is convicted. Please remember, in our customs and practices we have a particular common customs. Unless and until the person is convicted by the court, unless and until the person is found guilty, we cannot call him as long as the criminal. We cannot call him as long as the person guilty of an offense. So an offense is declared only when it is proved. Unless and until it is proved, we cannot declare him as long as the criminal, or we cannot declare him as long as the person who is of any part of the fraud. It is there. So this one side. So customs and usages normally whichever has been brought from the earlier, the same thing is normally the foundation for the present law. So this is one side which we have to remember when we look at customs and usages. Okay, customs and usages. So we find that normally basically our law today consists of two types there basically. The two types of law is consist of one side civil law and second side it is criminal law. Now let us discuss the first type of law, that is called as civil law. The civil law is normally anything which is of civil nature, where there is no involvement of element of crime. Please remember, where there is no crime involved. Okay, so such matters are treated as civil matters, and civil matters are discussed in civil law, and the matters are held in civil courts. In the civil courts, normally the following liberties are given normally to the respective parties. Suppose if the defendant is absent for any of the hearings, in such case an advocate can represent that defendant and then fight the case in the court. That is one thing. Second thing is normally he can also ask for the extension period, or he can ask for the time period for the next hearing. and he can request with the judge for the next hearing. That is also possible. And third thing is known as the there cannot be any kind of warrants issued by any of the parties, suppose in case if they are absent to the courts, and this can be intimated by through an advocate by giving valid reasons, and the next date can be asked. So these things are possible in the case of civil matters. Civil matters are normally dealt in Civil Procedure Code, CPC in short. Please remember, Civil Procedure Code. And second type of the law is called as a criminal law. In the case of criminal law, there involves an element of crime. The crime commonly involved are maybe cheating a person, committing a fraud, okay, one part, or normally say the decepting another person, deception, act of deception. And then normally we also find that normally say the if you again kill one person, killing, murdering, riot strike, and even normally religious strikes, normally see the making the person against to do such kind of acts, whichever is normally unauthorized, okay, or unlawful. So such type of things again are called as criminal acts. These criminal acts are dealt in Criminal Procedure Code, which we call it as CRPC. CRPC in short, Criminal Procedure Code. And these matters are normally held in criminal court. In the case of criminal court, normally the following liberties are not granted as in the case of civil courts. The following are the things. First one is, if the particular person is normally held as normally criminal, the notice will be issued to such party. Legal notice will be issued, and also a court notice will be issued. Upon receiving the court notice, the particular person has to be present at the same time told by the respective notice by the court itself. And at that time, normally, first of all, normally again, he will be heard, one thing. And second thing is that he cannot remain absent in the court normally again, of any time, is whatever has been told, because it is a criminal matter, not a civil matter. In civil matter, there are exceptions. Okay, second, third thing is, normally, his advocate can represent, but now along with the advocate, normally the person whoever is found guilty should be there. He cannot escape by giving any reason or any excuses from the court. That is one side. And suppose in case, if the person escapes from the court on that particular time, now again, see what happens is, the court will issue something called as NBW, non-bailable warrant. Why? Because it is non-bailable offense. So in such case, now again, we find that what happens is, the person will be brought through with the help of police. So ultimately what happens is, the criminal cases can turn more strong. Why? Because the person who is guilty remain absent from the court because of some reasons. Even the reason is valuable also, court will not accept the same. So in such case, come what may, the person whoever is declared as normally the criminal, or normally the person whoever is supposed to be present in the criminal case, cannot escape on that date in which hearing takes place. Okay. Only upon normally court permission, normally again, he is allowed so. So he is supposed to take the permission from the court well in advance by giving some valid reasons. If reasons are that valid, court will give the permission. If not, court will also not give permission for such parties to again escape from the date of hearing. So this is one side. So this criminal proceeding court is becoming very much tougher now. So earlier we can find normally the judgment were given delayed. There are many cases where normally the court is delayed with the judgment. Why? Because either because of insufficient evidence, or normally the declaration cannot be made, or sometimes normally the case cannot be concluded because of one or the other, so the misrepresentation of the facts. So in such case, normally what was happening is, there are prolonged justices for normally 10 and above years. But today what is happening is, normally the circular is issued to the court saying that a case cannot be delayed for more than 10 years. Okay. After 3 years, normally parties are given a chance, they are also called, they are also told, they are also counseled, they are also given a chance to normally to again compensate one another. So compensation can be made after a period of 3 years. If the parties feel that they can compensate, they can compensate there itself, get it to the view of the court, and court will approve the same. And after the court approves the same, normally it is declared as very clearly that the court, the case is concluded, judgment can be given there itself. But in case if the parties do not agree, the case can be extended till 10 years, and thereafter if the matter is so strong, it will take still more time, like that it happens. So these things are there as far as now is the respective criminal proceedings code are. So to conclude, what I can say is now is the source of mercantile law includes the following. First one is English mercantile law, which has come from English customs. Second is statute law based on the statute or the apex body. Third is judicial decisions, the decisions made by the judiciary which has the law making power. And fourthly, the customs and usage on the basis of Indian acts. Okay, these things are there. Thank you very much.